The most real review you will see on Kylie Jenner's new reformulated makeup. Because guys, I've literally tried Kylie Cosmetics once when I was like 13, so if I don't like something, you'll be able to tell on my face. Okay, so first up, we are trying the Kai brow. I'm gonna brush up my brows first, and then let's start applying. Oh, she pigmented. I got the shade medium brown, by the way. I'm trying to extend my eyebrow, but it's just getting a little bit sheer, so I'm gonna try build up the product. On camera, it doesn't look awful, but in real life, you can really tell where my brow ends. Okay, so now that the brow's on, I'm gonna try out the bronzer. Oh, this is in the shade Toasty, by the way. I don't know if I got the wrong shade. I might have done, but let's just apply that. Oh, that's super cute. Okay, I way prefer this to the eyebrow pencil. Yeah, I used it on my eyelid a little bit as well, but I actually love that bronzer. It blended so nice. I love the tone of it. I'll probably give it like a 9 out of 10 in total. I also forgot, but I got this brow highlighter, so I might as well try this out. I'm actually in love with that product. I've never found like a brow highlighter pen that I actually like because I feel like they always just don't blend easily. But this blended so easily, literally 10 out of 10. Okay, for blush, I got the shade Winterberry. Of course I had to, the bright pink one. Let's see how, oh, it's quite light. I don't know. Oh, it builds up nicely though. I don't like it when it's first applied, but it builds up really prettily. Ooh. Okay, so I'm obsessed with the formula. It's super pretty, super easy to apply. However, I'd probably rate this like a 7 out of 10, just because I personally love a metallic blush, and this is very matte, as you guys can see. Okay, so now going on with the highlighter, and first of all, I just want to say I'm obsessed with the printing on the product. Oh my god, so cute. Got the shade Ice Me Out, by the way, and let's see what this is like. Okay. That's pretty. I actually really like that. It's a super like glow from within kind of look. Guys, this might be one of my favorite powder highlighters ever. It gives you a super natural glow and it does not emphasize texture at all. I'm obsessed. Of course I had to get two lip kits, so I got the shade Kylie and Autumn. It'd be a crime not to use the shade Kylie, let's be real. Okay, oh my god, I love that lip liner already. Okay, so the lip liner's now on. It was so easy to apply, literally like 10 out of 10. Now going in with the lipstick on top. Okay, sorry, I had to apply some eye makeup because it was really throwing me off, but I'm actually obsessed with that. I like how the lipstick was slightly lighter than the lip liner because it blends into each other really nicely. And I can tell it's going to last a long time, but it's not drying at all. I got so many glosses, so comment for a part two.
Some festival hair inspo for you all. Section plus braid. Tie in ponytail. Other side.
Teaching beginners things I wish I knew about makeup when I first started because it has been a journey. Okay, so if I ever decide to use a more full coverage foundation, I will always, always, always go over it with at least bronzer or blush because if not, it starts to make your skin look really flat because you naturally have loads of different tones in your skin. So if you get rid of all of them, you just have no definition or shape to your face really. Concealer placement is so important. So on this side, I brought it more outwards and shaped it like this. So it'll bring my face out and add more emphasis to this side of my face. Whereas on this side, I focused it here, which will bring my face more in. And even though everyone says don't do your concealer like this, this can actually be more flattering on certain face shapes. I definitely did not know how to contour when I first started my makeup. I literally used to bring it all the way in and it just looked like a stripe of mud down my face. So what I like to do now is I like to keep it in line with the end of my eye. And that way we just make sure it's not coming too far in and it doesn't look muddy at all. So highlighter you're always told to apply to the high points of the cheeks, but where actually are the high points of the cheeks? Because I did not know. I thought they were like up here, but it's actually where your cheekbone comes out the furthest. So I like to apply it actually all the way down here now. So back in 2018, I became a professionally qualified makeup artist. And this is part I don't even know what anymore of exposing the best tricks I learned so you guys don't have to spend as much coin as I did actually going there. Even foundation does not come from the foundation you're using. It actually comes from how you prep the skin. So you want to make sure your skin is clean and then it's just nicely moisturized, whatever you want to do. But yeah, that's the most important step in any makeup routine. When picking a foundation shade, match it to your chest. So you guys can see this doesn't really match my face, but it does match my chest, so it's all good. Now, you guys know I love my translucent powder. However, if you put it all over your face, it can make it look a little bit ashy, especially if there's flash photography. So I take this under my eyes and in my smile lines. And then for the rest of my face, I'll take a tinted powder that matches my skin tone. This is the Charlotte Tilbury in the shade 2. And just pressing it on any other areas I want to set. If you want to create a round eye look, you want to focus the product here and here. And if you want to create a winged out eye look, you want to extend the product up and leave this part more blank. I want to do a winged out look as always, so that's just what I'm going to do. Tiniest bit of black or dark brown eyeshadow on the lower lash line just here will really help lift your eyes. I'm out of time, but comment if you want another part.
Pick an aesthetic. I think that I can get you out my head. You never ever let me forget. Cause just when I think you're gone, hear a song on the radio. Attempting to recreate this hairstyle. Hairstyles I'd wear if I was on Love Island. Three-step classic eye look. White base and set.
Define. All done.
To make you seem funnier, to make you seem cooler.
Maybe I just am funnier and cooler.
How to get perfect slick back pigtails.
Okay, I've got my timer set to 1 minute and I'm gonna do my 1 minute makeup look that actually does take 1 minute and you guys will see. So, brow gel, brush those brows up. Just a little bit. This is the Refi Beauty one, by the way, if you are interested. Lovely, done. Now, mascara, only on the outer corner, little natural vibe, right there. It helps like lift your eyes as well. There we go, one side done. Probably should cover up my spots, but also cannot be bothered. Other side. Oh my god, that will not go in. My timer is messing me up. Now, lips. This is the Tarte Maracuja Juicy Lip. And we're done in under 1 minute. There you go, 1 minute makeup. If you can never get your eyeliner even, I'm about to show you a life hack that should make it a whole lot easier. So first of all, you want to go in with a powder eyeshadow. I'm going to take this one from the Madison Beer palette. It's my favourite, you guys know. And then you just want to start sketching out the shape that you want your eyeliner to be in. So because this isn't anywhere as near as dark as like any eyeliner would be, it's a lot easier to clean up and conceal, and it will also give something for your eyeliner to blend into if it's not 100% perfect. And then now, because we already have the shape that we want, it'll be a whole lot easier to go in with the eyeliner, and all we have to do is follow the stencil that we already have there. And here you have it. It literally took me like 2 minutes to do the whole eyeliner, so thumbs up for me.
Pick an aesthetic.
That I can get you on my head. You never ever let me forget. Cause just when I think you're gone, here I'm song on the radio.